and Coach Smith was great because he would drive me, because Mountford Wilson, Virginia to Charlotte, I want to say that might have been like an hour and a half drive. So he used to drive me back and forth. So, you know, that kind of helped because it was a big adjustment. It was a big – I missed my family. I missed my friends. But I was a basketball guy. I wanted to get to college, to a big-time college. So, you know, that was the sacrifice at the time.
And this is the time when coaches were coaches. You had a structured system. And like you said, you're getting your grades together. And that's something, in my opinion, that – we don't, and in our community as a whole, we focus on the game more than the entire situation, the lifestyle, the career. And I'm glad to hear that you say, hey, I want to go down and get my life together, and I'm not trying to go to junior college, because even later on, but after you, we had people just saying, well, I'll go to junior college for a little while, and then I matriculate up. It's good to see that even as a young person, I'm quite sure your mom had anytime your mom is coming to talk to coaches, that means she has a great influence on you.
Right.
So big ups to you for that. Now, you're in New York City. You got your idol up over at Syracuse doing his thing. You got Mar is doing his thing up at St. John's. How did you end up in DePaul, Chicago, Illinois at DePaul?
Well, I mean, Chicago was top 5, top 10, top 15 program back then. You know, they had Mark McGuire, Terry Cummins. You know, they had some great teams with the great Ray Meyer. So another thing, we didn't have all these stations and channels. You know, there was no ESPN, there was no Fox. You know what I mean? We had NBC, CBS, ABC, but they only had a few games on every week. So DePaul played, I want to say, probably 8 times a year on national TV. They had 8 games, and then it was the WGN channel, which was nationwide. Mm-hmm. So I was on TV for every game. And DePaul also had, they had a pipeline to New York, New Jersey point guards. They had Gary Garland, Whitney
Kenny
Houston's
Patterson.
Brother. They had Kenny Patterson from Queens. I was a big Kenny Patterson fan. So, you know, DePaul didn't really have to recruit me a whole lot. I think I was more of a fan of them than they were of me. DePaul. I wanted to go to DePaul. You know, all along I was looking at all these other schools, but I was going to DePaul.
Wow. Well, you know, just for the record, who was your second choice?
Pittsburgh, University of Pittsburgh. And it's crazy because I just saw Charles Smith. Who played plenty of years in the NBA, played with the Knicks. But we talked about it. It would have been Charles Smith, Jerome Lane, Curtis Akins, Demetrius Gore. Like, we would have had a hell of a team at the University of Pitt.
I remember that team used to get Syracuse, Fitz, and Derek Coleman, and that crew.
Yeah. Yeah, no. It would have been incredible. But I was so into DePaul. You know, they were on TV. Like I said, I was a big Kenny Patterson fan. I love Mark McGuire, Terry Cummins. So I was, you know, I was basically, DePaul ain't have to do a whole lot of recruiting.
Okay. Now, you get off the plane, you're in Chicago. What's next?
I'm going to tell you this. I'll never forget this. First time I played ball in Chicago, I don't think the people in Chicago looked at me and I think they were like, man, he ain't that good. So, was it IIT or one of those places?
That's exactly what it was.
I'll never forget. I went to the pro-am. I don't know anybody. I forgot who put me on the team. So, I'm on the team and I'm playing with, I want to say it was Tracy Dildy. No, Tracy Dildy wasn't on my team. He was on somebody else's team. And we were playing against those guys. And they had another high school kid from Chicago. I forgot his name. And they started him, and I was pissed at that. You know, I was pissed. But, you know, I'm in a different environment. I don't know. So I'm on the bench, and they kind of put me in every now and then. So they put me in. I don't know. I might have turned it over. I might have missed a shot. They take me out. Then they put me in again. I don't know. I might have turned it over. And now Tracy Dildy was killing. He was on the other team. I think he was in high school. So I felt some kind of way, and I never went back and played in that. Since to this day, like my time in Chicago, I wouldn't play. because I was, and I was one of those, I was good at holding grudges, just put it that way. So I never played in that again. And that was my first, like, introduction to Chicago. And it's so funny because you know your town, right? I remember walking through the hallways and hearing people talking about me. You know what I mean? Like, they wasn't feeling it from in that gym that day. You know what I mean? It was like, man, dude, ain't that good. You know what I mean? So it was it was interesting. Yeah, it was interesting. It was interesting.
And you know what? That's so Chicago, man. That is so Chicago.
Yeah, but, well, they would have, but to be honest, they would have did that anywhere. They would have did that in Philly, D.C., New York, you know.
Oh, okay.
And I really didn't get a chance to play. And I really didn't play that well, but I wasn't on the court enough. But, you know, it was one of them things. I wasn't in my environment. So they playing by their own rules. They play their high school dude, which they supposed to do, you know, play their high school kids, you know. And, you know, they threw me in there, you know, when, you know, I guess when they felt like it. But it was basically like, man, you in Chicago, man. You know, you ain't getting preferential treatment over here.
Yeah. Because, you know, then we were still trying to fight, you know, like, in New York, you looking at GN and y'all seeing these other guys, but we not, you know, there is no internet, there is no Twitter, and we going, man, we need respect. And then we got a New York guy here, we treat him bad. We, you know, you gonna earn everything you get. I already know what it looks like. You gonna earn everything.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Because one of my most vivid memories is Isaiah Thomas making your man Kenny Patterson look real bad at an IAAF tournament.
Listen to me. Listen to me. What was that in? I was there. Was that at the push game?
Yes. Yeah.
Was that at the push down game?
On one knee,
Reverend Jesse Jackson? Spoken.
Yeah. I was there.
I remember that. Like,
it was brutal.
It was brutal.
Yes, it was real. Because Kenny ripped them a couple times, and it was like, oh, no, this is my town. And now I got to get you.
Yeah. And Kenny was cocky.
Oh, yeah.
Super cocky. And you know Isaiah, you know Zeke wasn't having that at all.
Oh, yeah. Not in his town. I mean, that's probably the reason him and Mike got so much friction, because Mike took over the town and he's like, oh, no. This is Mike.
Yeah.
So now we transition into DePaul, you know, north side of Chicago. That is one of the most eclectic parts of town. It's Chicago, but it's not Chicago. How you getting in at DePaul?
DePaul was great. I mean, it's basketball. You know, at the end of the day, it's basketball. So the environment was cool. My teammates, you know, I came in with a really good freshman class with Terrence Green from Flint, Michigan, Stanley Brundy from California. And we had some really good vets. We had Tony Jackson there, Kevin Holmes, Marty Embry, you know, Dallas Commingees was there. So, you know, we had some leadership, but we were the young guns coming in, and we had some really good, cool, humble guys on our team. So we kind of blended together pretty well. Wound up having a pretty decent first year. You know, took a lot of L's. I think we wound up 16-12 or something like that. Got into the NCAA tournament. Mm-hmm. Went to the Sweet 16, probably went further than people thought. Lost to Duke in the Sweet 16 to go to the Elite Eight. So it was a great experience. It was a great start to, you know, to my DePaul career.
I remember you and David Rivers used to go at it something serious.
Yes.
Talk to me about those experiences, because I mean, cats in Chicago, by this point, you are a celebrity. You know, people, you got the approval now. You know, it's no longer the New York guy. We've actually adopted you. You may not have known
for
me,
sure.
You were damn near Chicagoan at that point. So, talk to me about these David Rivers battles, because those were epic.
Yeah, and to the Chicago thing, I knew it. I love Chicago. Chicago showed me so much love, and to this day, they still do. So that's like one of my cities. But no, the David Rivers, man, it was then, because the first year I got in college, David Rivers was a sophomore. And I remember we played on national TV, and he got the best of me. You know, I was kind of, you know, I'm the new dude on national TV. You know, he had experienced that already. I hadn't. So, you know, I had a decent game, but he totally outplayed me. And I remember after that game, like, I'm going to get him. You know what I mean? There ain't going to be no more of this. You know, after that, we battled. You know, we had great battles. I have so much respect for David Rivers. He was tough, man. And, you know, every time we playing, you know, that was a big rivalry. And it was the matchup between me and him. So it was exciting all the time. You know, so big ups to David Rivers. You know, great dude, great college player.
Yeah. So at this point, it's UNT Green. Stanley Brundy is coming into his own. Y'all pick up Kevin Evans.
Yep.
Now the city is on fire.
Yeah, that was the turning point. Kevin Edwards was a big piece, right? Because, you know, we lost all the older guys. We had Dallas, and we had, you know, the three of us with Stanley, T, and myself. But we needed some more offense. And I don't know which one of those guys recruited Kev. I got to ask them that. But they did a great job because Kev came out of nowhere. And right away, as soon as Kev stepped on campus, I was like, wow, okay. Because, you know, we used to go to Hayes Healy. Well, I got to tell you a story. Well, my first time at DePaul, my freshman year, there's a guard there. I can't think of his name. He's from Mississippi. So Dallas Comedies and all these guys, when I first get on campus, we eat, and they keep talking about how, you know, we're going to get it on for this spot, me and this other dude. And they amping it up. They pumping it up, you know. And, you know, I'm a quiet dude but confident. The other guy was a quiet dude. And so they pumping it up. I'll never forget. It was a gym called Hayes Healy on campus, a real small gym. And that's where we used to go play and have some really good games. So we went in there, we played, and, you know, next thing you know, he was leaving town. he got out of there probably about a week or two later. I'm referencing that because when Kev came in, again, we was over at Hayes Healy. You know, that was kind of the gym. You know what I mean? That's where you was going to get tested at. And so Kev came in to Hayes Healy, and it was like deja vu. Kev came in, and Kev was doing work. You know what I mean? Played real well. And I was like, wow, this kid is like, you know, this dude is really good. And so I knew with Kev, with T. Green, Stanley Brundy, and myself, you know, that's a hell of a core. And then, you know, obviously we got Dallas Comedies. That's self-explanatory. So Kev was the missing piece. Kev made us a much better team than we would have been without him. You know, he was that guy in the backcourt. He could shoot the ball. You know, when I passed him the ball, you know, I felt like it was going in. And then we had T. Green who could shoot the ball, you know, who could play D. You know, T. Green, you know, he did it all. He did a little bit of everything. And he was that. He was like our mojo, quiet as kept. You know, he was that energy. He was that dude. You know, we walk in the war. You want to walk in with T. Green. He was that kind of guy. And he had offense, and he could pass the ball. So he was that all-around, do-it-all kind of guy. Then you had Stanley, who just basically was around the rim, running the court, get every rebound, make every layup, was satisfied in his role and his position. And then you had Dallas, who was the wild card. You know, Dallas, the one thing about Dallas, though, when we played scrubby teams or teams that weren't that good, you wouldn't see the full Dallas. But when the lights turned on, the real lights, he was special all the time. You know, so we had, you know, we had a really good nucleus and a really good five, and we had guys coming off the bench. So we had a great year that year.
What are some of your most difficult losses? Because, again, most people don't know, you know, Michael Jordan is in town at this point, but the DePaul Blue Team is out of show.
Yeah, people don't know that.
Understand
people
that.
Don't know that.
Yeah.
That's a great, people don't really understand that. When we was at DePaul, we were the basketball of that town. But, you know, the losses, I never forget my man Mousy, too. He's from New York, Mouse McFadden. He went to was he at Indiana at the time? No, he's at Cleveland State. I think he went to Indiana, transferred to Cleveland State. Cleveland State came into DePaul our first year.
Okay.
And matter of fact, I think they had just beat Indiana. And then they came and beat us, or vice versa, one of them.